In another video, we learned about the differentiator and integrator circuits on an analog synthesizer, which show up as the high-pass filter and low-pass filter, respectively. In this video, we will look at other applications of the integrator circuit, converting a gate signal to an envelope function, creating glide effects from one pitch to another, and converting one envelope function to a related but slower envelope function. First, let's hear a square wave through a low-pass filter to review our previous use of the integrator circuit. What we see here in green is the waveform of the square wave on the oscilloscope, and as we let only the low frequencies pass through, we see the square wave transformed into an almost triangle wave shape. This is the idea we want to keep in mind as we look at the integrator application through what is called the slew limiter. First, changing a gate signal to an envelope function. A gate signal is caused by a square wave function with a low frequency. We used these gate signals to trigger a drum machine in the video on oscillators. A gate signal simply sends an on-off signal. We can think of the top of the square wave as on and the bottom of the square wave as off. The high voltage is at the top and low voltage is at the bottom. The slew limiter can take this gate signal as an input and slow down the change in voltage from low to high and vice versa. This output is simply an attack decay envelope, which could be applied to a filter, amplifier, or to the pitch of an oscillator. It takes the extreme discrete change between off and on and changes it to a slower rise and fall through all of the values in between. Let's hear the difference with the effect on volume of the amplifier. First, by just applying the square wave to the amp, and then applying the square wave through the slew limiter to the amp. And while we are listening to the differences, we will look at the square wave gate signal on the oscilloscope, and also the resulting wave after running the square wave through the slew limiter. What we can notice on the oscilloscope is the same thing we saw with the low-pass filter. The square wave is starting to have an almost triangle wave shape after transformation. So, why is this called an integrator? What sort of integration is happening here? In the video demonstrating the high-pass and low-pass filters, we discovered that we could differentiate a triangle wave to create a square wave by using a high-pass filter. We could then undo this by integrating the square wave back to a triangle wave using a low-pass filter. We have now just seen a similar idea. The horizontal lines of the square wave gate signal were integrated to become the slopes of the attack and decay parts of the envelope. However, this particular slew limiter on the Make Noise Maths module allows us to shape the attack and decay parts of the envelope to other curves besides linear. This is important because there are exponential functions at work with how we hear sound waves, and we would like to synthesize that with electronic instruments. Additionally, if we use logarithmic or concave down curves, we get slower results than with linear, and if we use exponential or concave up curves, we get faster results than with linear. Our next example demonstrates gliding between notes. A glide between notes is called a glissando or portamento and can be heard with acoustic instruments like the trombone, violin, and guitar. We can synthesize this on electronic instruments using a slew limiter. First, we'll start with a simple four-note sequence. The notes change the pitch on a synthesizer by changing voltage. For each change of 1 volt, the pitch changes by an octave. So for example, if we increase voltage by 1, then the pitch increases by 1 octave. And it's important to note that this also means the frequency, measured in hertz, doubles. These are immediate changes, similar to the immediate changes from the gate signal of a square wave. We can see these changes in voltage by observing the voltage output from the sequencer on the oscilloscope in red. Now let's run the voltage from the sequencer output through the slew limiter. We can hear the pitch rise and fall through all frequencies between those set by the sequencer. If we slow down the sequencer and also increase the rise and fall time on the slew limiter, we can hear this more dramatically. On this particular slew limiter from synthesizers.com, there is one knob that controls the attack and decay time and sets them to be the same value. It is important to note that the curves on this slew limiter are concave down or logarithmic as the pitch rises and concave up or exponential as the pitch decreases. This is a very common trait with portamento on electronic instruments. For our last example, we will use an envelope as the input to the slew limiter. As covered in another video, an envelope is a function that has four settings: attack, decay, sustain, and release. Except sustain, which is a set voltage level, these are all changes in voltage, and we can influence these changes further with a slew limiter. First, let's use the oscilloscope to see the shape of the envelope function we'll use. Next, I'll use the slew limiter again from make noise, so I can use the linear setting, and I will pass this envelope through it. I have the rise and fall times on the slew limiter set to be the same, and what we can notice is that the attack, decay, and release times have all been slowed down. Also, the envelope does not reach as high of a peak as it did before, and the sustain level has been lowered. So, this slew limiter has decreased all aspects of the envelope function. The integrator circuit behind the slew limiter has many uses outside of sound synthesis. One of them is with analog-to-digital converters. These converters are used to record information in digital form. Your phone does it when it takes a photo or records your voice. In fact, we saw them at work in this video when we were using the oscilloscope, which is a digital representation of analog sound. In electronic music, portamento is a feature added to almost all synthesizers, so glide from one note to the next can be added to the music. Here's an example.